The Joe Rogan Experience.
Ferrari is 100% douchebag.
They take themselves very seriously.
It's really hard to not be a douchebag in a Ferrari. Mm-hmm. But although I did see a really interesting one that this guy built in England where he took a Dino.
Oh, yeah.
And he put a 400-plus horsepower modern Ferrari engine in it and put like a clear glass over the engine bay and everything you could take off and bring the car back to stock.
It was almost the sort of singerization of a Dino. So the Dino is one of the prettiest Ferraris ever, right?
Car.
But if you've ever driven one, they sound great, but they're just slow as dog shit. Yeah. I mean, they're the V6s. It's for the smallest engine Ferrari ever made.
What did you know the website for the guy that did it or the YouTube channel?
I think his name was David Lee and he built it. And it's, he claimed it was an F40 engine, which I don't think was entirely accurate.
I think he exaggerated
a little bit. I think it's an engine from like a 360
that
has been modified
sense.
In certain ways.
Because an F40 has more than 400 horsepower.
Well, it also had turbos, and it's not like you just wouldn't use an F40 engine for that. Right. It would be like using something that's very valuable and not really replaceable for purposes of modification doesn't make much sense when other options are available that could deliver you the same result.
Like a 360, what did a 360 have when it came with the Modena?
Like 400 horsepower. 400-ish? Yeah, like around 400.
And
the
Dino's got to be like, what is it, like 2,500 pounds?
Maybe. They're tiny. They're tiny and they're made of nothing. I mean, they're 2,500 is maybe a good number.
It looks
they're
so
little.
Wild.
Yeah, and I've heard that car. That car lives here.
Really?
Yeah, that car lives in Los Angeles.
No
the black
way.
One? Yeah, it lives here. I've seen it at car shows. Yeah.
That's got to be
$500,000
car, right?
Business. It's weird because you actually have to, yes, it probably is, $500,000 would be a very low estimate for
so
that
like
car.
So like $700,000.
Maybe. Yeah. A really good original Dino is
Look
half.
At
there
that.
It is. So it's actually...
That's not the car, because the car has a hard top, or is it a Targa?
It's a Targa. It's a Targa.
Oh, look how pretty it is.
It's
look at
better
that picture.
With the roof off, isn't
look
it?
Look at that picture with the back end of it right there. Yeah, man. Click on
so,
that.
So what's so interesting about
it's
the car
like
is...
a Corvette.
It's actually hard to tell it apart from a regular Dino if you don't know what you're looking for. The things to look for, obviously that badge on the left that says like Evo something, and then the clear engine cover with the big bubble in the middle of the engine bonnet has changed.
Yeah, by the way, that badge can go fuck itself.
The badge doesn't need to be there. Yeah, the
Get
badge
that
doesn't
off
need to be
there.
The exhaust is a little bigger.
I like the exhaust.
That's fine.
I wish they had some grip to the tires. Those are some skinny ass, bitch ass tires.
Well, look how narrow. I mean, you know, you're talking about a car that without widening the body, there's only so much you can do.
Right.
I imagine a modern rubber compound. Mm. What they did was they reproduced the Dino's, I think they're Campagnolo wheels, which were probably like 15s on the Dino, and I think they're 17s here.
So pretty.
That, you want to talk expense. Yeah, David Lee, the Monza 3.6 Evo Dino. So 3.6, that's what tells me it's a
Modena.
360 engine.
Yeah,
3.6. If it was a F40 engine, it'd be a 2.8 liter engine.
Oh,
yeah.
With turbos,
yeah.
God, that's a pretty car. Look
Which,
at
by
that.
The way, if it had an F40 engine, it'd be a fucking death trap.
Right?
You would sail that thing right off a cliff.
With 400 horsepower, it's got to be crazy fast.
Yeah, but you know what? It's going to be linear, right? Without the turbo spool, you know, you have that natural build of power, and you really kind of can just use less throttle. It won't just jump out at you.
Yeah.
But, I mean, God, you are a man of taste. Joe, that's awesome.
It's a beautiful ride. Look at that thing.
They're selling them.
They're trying to build.
Yeah, they're trying to build a run of them.
Oh God!
I think they're
like
Singer.
Yeah.
But here's the problem with doing this with Ferraris, though. Ferrari people, even if you did something to the level of Singer, Ferrari people aren't really like that. Ferrari people are originality over everything.
That's so weird.
I
don't understand.
They don't like
folks.
They don't like modifying the cars. They don't like a car that's previously been modified. It's all about that numbers matching shit.
I don't get it.
It's not for you.
No,
it's not really for me either. I love driving the Ferraris, but like I don't align with like
that.
The Ferrari fan really values so much. But I'd like to own one soon. Maybe an '80s one.
What would
Something
you
a
like?
Little silly.
Like a Testarossa?
I've driven Testarossas. They're fun.
Yeah. Dana White has a Testarossa.
The maintenance is crazy.
And he had it completely redone. He's like, fuck you. We put a new interior in it, a modern stereo, everything.
It's probably nice. They need a lot of maintenance, though. Testarossas have timing belts. See, timing belts. delts are something that Italians were doing for a long time, and that they should just never be done again.
That sounds terrible.
They wear out, and they need to be changed. And in the case of the Testarossa, you're talking about a giant flat 12 engine. They're in the front. So they're up against the firewall behind the seats. Oh, so you have to take off the whole back of the car and take the whole engine out of the car to do these timing belts. Starting with the modern stuff, they use chains. They brought that into the 21st century, and they don't have to fucking fuck with belts anymore.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. But even like Lamborghini at the time, like I have a Countach, which is the best car ever made, and you don't have to do that bullshit because even Lamborghini used chains. So you don't need to do the engine out.
Why did Ferrari go with belts?
I think they thought it was smoother. Enzo Ferrari also had utter contempt for the people who bought his streetcars, and I wouldn't be surprised if he did it just so the dealers would make more money on the services, even if he knew it was worse.
Why did he have so much contempt for the people who bought his cars?
Enzo Ferrari just wanted to go racing. He was an egomaniac, and all he ever wanted to do was see his cars win races, and he came to a point where he couldn't make money doing that, and he had to sell streetcars to customers. But throughout his entire life, he openly treated those people with disdain. That's how you win. That's the story of Lamborghini. The story of Lamborghini is Ferruccio Lamborghini had a Ferrari. It was not working for one reason or another. He went to Ferrari to complain about it. Enzo basically told him to go fuck himself. And so he said, I'll build a better car. And that's the story of Lamborghini.
And what are they owned by now?
Lamborghini is owned by Audi? Volkswagen Audi Group. Okay. Yeah, VAG.
So they're more reliable now.
Yes, but so are Ferraris. Around 2010-ish, when the 458 came out, mm-hmm. Ferraris took a massive jump in reliability.
How'd they do that?
First off, the big one was the dual clutch gearbox, which... stick shifts were one thing, right? And then these early single clutch paddle shift gearbox, they'd fry clutches like crazy. People didn't really know how to use them right, and they'd ride the clutches out, and they would just go through clutches like crazy. The dual clutch cars have much more like fail-safe type stuff built into them, and they actually work properly.
But Ferrari used to have the gated shifter, which is one of the coolest things ever. The clinkety clink.
It's the best.
Sliding into gears.
Yeah. There's nothing more rewarding than like banging a Ferrari off the rev lever.
So why did they stop that?
People stopped. The problem with Ferrari is that they're new, with the problem with all new exotic, the first owners of exotic cars, is they want that new technology that's from racing. And also it's improved the drivability. If you want to buy a Ferrari or a Lamborghini and drive it around in the city and use it as like a car, you could buy a Ferrari right now and it could just be your car. Like that wasn't a thing you could do really in the 70s or 80s or even 90s. Like you could literally use a modern exotic car, be it Ferrari, Lamborghini, McLaren, Audi, R8, whatever, that could be your only car now. And that the gearbox technology is a lot of what's made that possible, and computer controlled like engine management systems.
God, though.
It's a little disappointing.
One thing I'm really happy that Porsche hasn't done that, but they have with the GT3 RS.
GT3 RS.
This last year, and now the new ones.
What do you mean, only automatics?
All automatics.
Well, the RS, though, the RS is, in Porsche speak, is the fastest version of what they can build. They have the GT3 Touring with a stick. That's the one you want. You want the Touring.
Why do I want the Touring?
Because it's a fucking stick. Because the 4-liter engine with that 6-speed gearbox is the best engine transmission combination available in cars today, period. Yeah.